YouTube, what is up? Welcome back to another video, and we're back in the Mecca, back in Manchester. So we haven't recorded a session in FLF in quite some time, so time to bring it back, and we're training back today. So we're bringing it back for our back session, all right? So big pull session today. We're going to just go through it, run through it. I'm going to keep it somewhat raw, going to talk my way through it, give you whatever tips and tricks I can along the way as well, okay? So sit back, relax, click like, subscribe, all that shit, and let's get into it. We're going to start off with the prime lat pull down. So this is like the heaviest lat pull down in the world, pretty much. I will run through how we're going to load that now in a second. So prime lat pull down, then we're going to move on to the extreme row, so upper back kind of focus row, then onto a single arm lat row, just a cable, more upper back work, some biceps, and then also some rear delts. So that's pretty much that. Every pull session has a similar enough layout for me, like if it isn't a direct pull session. So my other pull day, for example, is like a density day, so there's a bit of legs in there, a bit of posterior, whereas today is just solely pull. So when I am programming a pull session, it's always going to be lat first, especially a pull down, because people might have a big back, but your back can never be big enough in terms of width. The wider the back, always the better. I've never ever seen anyone or heard of anyone, even professional bodybuilders, that have too wide of a back. It's not a thing. So you need to be building up that weight. So starting off with that pull down when you're fresh, when you're strong, then getting onto, you know, a chest supported row or some sort of bent over row for that density, and then back to lat, back to upper back again for more thickness. So yeah, gonna get into it. Right, so with this, that pull down, it is plate loaded and it is a prime piece as well, so we can just kind of manipulate the movements to what way we want it to work. So what we're going to do here is I'm just going to have equal loading on the top pin and the middle pin. So that's going to be like mid and lengthen range. Now, there's just no real point loading this in the shortened range because it's just extremely fucking heavy as it is. And they already, I suppose, bias the shortened range, the machines as they are. So when you're loading that mid and lengthen range, you're still going to be getting it in the shortened range. And right now as well, just where we're trying to work, that lat is just so strong up in that lengthen range, I want to get the most out of it. So two sets here. First set is going to be 50-50 lengthened and mid, and then we're going to go predominantly lengthened, small bit mid. I think there's like two of these in the UK, I'm pretty sure, here in Ultraflex. It could be one or two other more. I don't think there's any in Ireland. So yeah, that's one of the benefits of obviously being over here, the equipment we've access to.
They call me Lord and my dog and I can see. I'm trying to be what I'm destined to be, and niggas trying to take my life away.
That is the heaviest that pull down in the world.
Put a hole in a nigga for fucking with me. My back on the wall, now you gon' see. Better watch how you talk when you talk about me. Cause
yeah, it's very heavy. Very heavy. The machine is very heavy as a whole. When it comes to machines like this, if you don't know what you're doing, just put it in the middle pin, play it safe. But if you do know what you're doing, then play around with it. I have a very, very Alex Hormozy inspired outfit today. Bar the shoes. I should be wearing Birkenstocks.
Come and take your life away, many men. Many men wish death on me, Lord. I don't cry no more. Don't look to the sky no more. Have mercy on me.
So when you are training bilateral movements, okay, one arm at a time, take some rest in between your sets. If you think that you can go from that side straight onto this side without having any carry across fatigue, you're misinformed, okay? Because you will. There's systemic fatigue. So just because I work left flat here, I can guarantee you if I jump straight into my right without taking a break, I'm still going to be fatigued from the set I just did previously. So take 30 seconds, a minute if needs be, before you go on to that next side.
Pussy niggas put money on my head, gone. Get your refund, motherfucker, I ain't dead. I'm the diamond in the dirt that ain't been found. I'm the underground king and I ain't been crowned. When I round, something special happen every time. I'm the greatest.
Right, so onto our extreme row now, which is our second movement of the day. So this is like your mid-back or upper back movement. Quite a heavy machine, again. So these prime pieces that are the plate load piece seem to be heavy enough. Again, loading it 50-50, mid and top. And then what we're going to do is actually drive elbows out and away from the body on this one. So the direction of where your elbow travels in line with your body will dictate how much back is going to be used or which part of the back is going to be used. So if your elbow is coming down in towards your hip, that's going to be lat. Okay, lat focused stuff, I'll have my elbow finished on my hips, like my lat pull down, my lat rows, and anything kind of upper backy or kind of mid back would be more so elbows out like 45 degrees. And then if you're looking for like rear delts, kind of upper back stuff again, you're looking out 90 degrees. So that'll dictate what part of the back is being used.
Like Ali in this prime, I walk the block with the bundles, I've been knocked on the humble.
Right, onto the back offset now. So I actually kept the exact same weight, 425 kg, what's that, 100 kg, 100 kilos each side, but just changed from two plates to one plate and three plates. So more, I suppose, more of a challenge in the lengthen range now than the mid, where I'm still strongest in the lengthen range. Should be able to hit the top, even though it is the same weight across the board, I should be able to hit higher rep range.
Show your ass with my gun, gotta tip a nigga, go ahead, lose your head. Turn your back on me, get clapped and lose your legs. I walk around, gun on my waist.
So you can see that. Same weight overall, just different ways of loading it and twice the amount of reps. So this goes to show different areas of your back are still stronger in sessions. So if you can learn how to manipulate movements and train sessions, that you still get the most out of it throughout, where you're training your strongest body part or the strongest part of your back later in the session, you can still lift heavy weight. I'm gassed after that one. My waist. Chip on my shoulder top, bust a clip in your face. Right, so on to our third movement today, which is a single arm cable lat row. So again, we had a lat pull down first, then we had like a mid back, upper back sort of row, and now again we're onto some lat row. So some spinal loading in this now, and the cable again for a good, fairly even resistance profile. Again, when I was speaking about kind of targeting your lat, obviously the big tip for that is going to be driving your elbow into your pocket or into your hip. But not even only that, but driving your elbow down into your pocket. Think about wrapping your elbow around your back. You'll really, really feel that in your lat. Right, so another 16 reps there. And as you can see, that is like a top set, 16 reps. So what I'll do in this scenario is I'll just keep the weight the same, as it's pretty much stacked up now. There's no extra weights to add. I'll keep the weight the same for my back offset, and hopefully, you know, hit somewhat similar rep range. Wish death on me, Lord, I don't cry no more. Don't look to the sky no more. Have mercy on me, have mercy on my soul. Somewhere my heart turned cold. Have mercy on many men. Right, that's that movement done. So we're going to move on now to, again, some upper back work. So lat work, upper back work, lat work, upper back slash mid back work. Right, so on to our next movement, which is going to be like an upper back pull down. So this is like upper back, even kind of rear delty. So I'm going to intentionally be lying back on this, leaning back far enough, okay, just to target that upper back and also driving my elbows slightly out away from me, okay? I look at this and you might think, oh, it's a lat pull down. And it actually even says on the machine that's a lat pull down, but it's not. It's an upper back pull down, okay? If you want a lat pull down, you need to get your elbow here. There's no way with this machine you'll be able to get your elbow in there. So this works a lot better for your upper back. Many, 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 many men. Wish death on me. Sunny days wouldn't be special if it wasn't for rain. Joy wouldn't feel so good. Right, so you see from today's session, we've four movements. Three out of those movements have all been used on prime equipment. So obviously a lot of you are not going to have access to this, so don't get disheartened. You can easily make alternatives. You have your prime pull down that you did at the start. Use a cable lat pull down instead of that single arm. We had our stream row, which is a chest supported row, standard one. You have single arm cable, everyone can do that. And then upper back pull down with prime, use your standard straight bar lat pull down. Do you know what I mean? So don't get too caught up, because you don't have the perfect equipment and you can't manipulate resistance profiles, all that kind of shit. How many years ago do you reckon this was? How many years? 4 years. Mad, isn't it? Right, so onto preacher curl, and see this bad boy here. This is the axis of rotation. So every machine is going to have something like that. Your leg extensions, your leg curls, tricep movements, anything like that is going to have an axis of rotation. What you want to do is you want to have the joint that you're using or that's involved in the movement in line with this. So for me, this is going to be my elbow. So I want to make sure my elbow is in line with the axis of rotation on this to align things properly for us, okay, to get the most out of the movement. Death gotta be easy, cause life is hard. It'll leave you physically, mentally, and emotionally scarred. This is for my niggas on the block, twisting trees and cigars. For the niggas on lock, doing life behind bars. I don't see only God can judge. Playing Eminem tunes today, happy this. Will the real Slim Shady please stand up? So, three sets on the preacher curl there, another three sets now on a dumbbell curl. So, admittedly, previously, I really kind of neglected arms. Coming towards the end of sessions, if I had to kind of, you know, get two sets instead of three sets, or kind of rush my way through them and superset them, I would have done it. Whereas now, I put a big, big emphasis on arms, like massive emphasis on arms, and I'm just not fucking leaving anything in the tank on them. So definitely seeing, you know, a positive return on that. I remember one thing I was told when I was younger is, if your bicep don't go above your shoulders, which mine don't really, yeah, they don't, it means you have shit arms. So I have shit arms. And until my bicep is above my shoulder, I'll have shit arms. And I'll continue to tell myself I have shit arms. It needs to be better. So that's why I'm really, really focusing and working on it at the moment. Right, so on some dumbbell curls after a preacher. Really quickly, why I'm doing them after the preacher, even though with that preacher curl, I was able to manipulate water resistance profile. So with a dumbbell, it's quite easy here. There's really no tension. And then it gets hard, hard, hard. Drops off a little bit up here. Okay, I can hold it here for quite some time. Whereas here, I really can't hold that. I can't hold that. So we're working now that mid to lengthen range, okay, in comparison to, I had it on setting four there in the preacher for the shortened range. So again, it's a bit more advanced, and to be honest, not really something that a lot of people need to worry about. But if you do want to know, there you go. It's clear. Quick, these crackers will give my black ass 100 years. I'm like Paulie and Goodfellas. You can call me. Actually, I haven't had just strictly a pull day in like 2.5 years. Because my first pull day of the week from on a Wednesday, was density. So it was posterior, there was deadlift, there was hamstring curls, there was adductors, there was a bit of pull added on at the end. And then my second pull day on my split was like an upper day. So it was push and pull, it was chest and back. But only since prep finished and as of the last couple of months have I had just a direct pull day. And I'm definitely feeling the benefits of it. Okay, I think my back definitely isn't a lot lagging body part, but it does need to be better. And I think having a full day just assigned just the pull, just the back, is really, really going to benefit me now long-term wise. So on to our final movement of the day, which is going to be just a rear delt fly. So I train rear delts on pull days and push days twice per week. On my delts and arm session and then on my pull session. So yeah, you can never really have big enough rear delts, can you? That's what we're looking for here. Just finish off with a bit of rear delts and then that is the session pretty much wrapped up and done and done.
Big Malcolm by any means with my gun in my palm. Slim switch sides on me. Let niggas ride on me. I thought we was cool. Why you want me to die, homie? Many men.
With the rear delt fly, it's actually a really, really, really easy movement that a lot of people fuck up, okay? All you need to do is set up so that your hands are about eye level or just below eye level in front of you and just drive your pinkies away to about 90 degrees to the body, hold and back. What I always, always, always see clients do is drive away, 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 away and their hands are almost touching each other behind each other, which is just gonna fuck up your shoulders and give you an injury. So drive pinkies away so that your hand is 90 degrees to the body, hold it there and slow control on the way back. Right guys, so that is it for another session. It's actually a really good session today. So pretty simple, you know what I mean? Like basic in terms of four main pulling movements, two lat movements, two kind of mid and upper back movements, two movements for biceps and one movement for rear delts, okay? So very easy structure that a lot of you guys can follow back home and, you know, I suppose base your own pull sessions off that depending on kind of what equipment you have as well, obviously making some adjustments. But as I said, it's my first proper official pull day for the first time in like 26 months. I was running my last split. Now I've been running this for the last couple of weeks, couple of months, but still finding my groove with it and really, really enjoying it. So hopefully, you know, next time I get up on stage, when I turn to the rear, lights out. That's the goal. Please like, subscribe, comment, all that YouTuber shit, and I'll see you in the next one.